Extra special warning. Our hosts do no research and preparation for these movies. They are just two cynical douchebags. They think just because they have 10 years of bad TV under their belts, they are qualified to review these horrible movies.
So before I say anything in this fucking review, before I do the intro and everything, I just have to say, fuck this movie. Fuck this movie. Alright, on that note. Hey everybody, Bart Gutter here. We are here with one of the final two Christmas episodes of the fucking year.
Yeah.
And I guess this is another of the worst movies on YouTube. Netflix episode thing again.
I don't know.
Because I'd sit there going Netflix.
Merry Christmas.
And look, wow, I don't want to do Christmas with the Cranks. Fuck that boring, fucking not funny bullshit, right?
That's just.
Then we got Santa Paws. Santa Paws 2. And then we were even contemplating doing Hercules Saves Christmas. And no, not a human, a fucking talking dog named Hercules. Because if it was Kevin Sorbo Saves Christmas, I'm all fucking about it. We would have done that in a fucking second. But no, it was a talking dog, and no.
Yeah, we're just not doing the talking dog thing.
Yeah, so what did we do since last week on Worst Movies on YouTube, or would that be tomorrow? No, that would be last week on Worst Movies on YouTube. We were supposed to do Christmas Season Massacre, but because of circumstances, we did two short films, Dear Santa and Dear Santa fucking 2. So now we're here, and we're doing it for Worst Movies on YouTube, Netflix fucking thing, blah.
Blah.
And I'm kind of glad we didn't do it for regular Worst Movies on YouTube, because there was not much to fucking show in this fucking movie.
Not really.
I mean, there would have been, we could have showed some stuff and made it an entertaining episode nonetheless, but.
Yeah, we could have.
But still, yeah.
I don't want to do this to them.
I don't want to do this now.
I
don't want
to show it. I wouldn't want to show it to our audience. I don't want you to see this.
But anyway, like, did I say it already? It is Christmas Season Massacre.
Oh, I heard you like this.
And it all starts off with this fucking chick running through this woods. Like, woods-filled fucking place, yeah. And she's being chased by this fucking dude in a fucking wife beater with a long mustache, you know. A fucking eye patch with a Christmas tree on it, a red bandana, and one shoe.
Yeah.
He kills her.
Cut off short thing.
Yeah, he stabs her and stabs the fuck out of her and pulls and plays in her guts for what like, seems like fucking 5 minutes. Because this movie is only 1 hour 9 minutes long, but.
And like the music, the sound effects and all this stuff never fit.
That was great.
It was
great,
all like sci fi.
The sound effects were my favorite fucking part of the whole fucking movie.
It was like
movie.
They were going in space and shit.
Yeah. Bling, boom, boom, bing, bong, boom, boom. It really was. Those were the sound effects of this Christmas horror movie. Christmas horror movie.
Right. That had
very, very, very little to do about
Christmas.
No, very little, right?
Very little.
So after fucking the one shoot guy, I don't even want to say his name yet.
Yeah.
He's playing in the guts forever. We get credits with generic punk music over top.
Yeah.
I gotta ask, what the fuck is up with these fucking awful, not even just awful, just low budget, micro budget fucking movies that's always fucking generic punk music?
No.
Why?
I don't know. You know? Dude, there's a garage band in every town.
There's multiple garage bands in every town, And you know, you go, hey, you want to put your music in my movie? They're always like, yeah, because fuck, we did it. Want to put your music in our awful TV shows? Yes? Okay. You know?
Well, yeah, you know, I mean, you gotta get your music out there somehow.
But yeah, anyway, generic punk music, moving the fuck on.
Hooray!
Oh yeah, but in the credits, it is great though, because there is somebody named Jason Christ.
Jason Christ.
And that is not their character name. It is the fucking name of on the fucking credits. Yeah,
Jason Christ.
But anyway, moving on from Jason Christ.
Yes, moving on, please, from Jason Christ. All praise be.
We get a shot of all praise be to Jason Christ. We get a fucking shot of the woods and it's like Toyota fucking Camry or whatever fucking pulls up and it says Christmas Town, California, Christmas Eve. Does that enter to say 2001 or something? I don't know. This movie was made in 2001.
Was it?
But whatever, it's this dude and this chick, and they're in this car, you know, and this dude's supposed to be the coolest, super coolest guy ever.
Ah, he's with his super shaved cool, head, man.
His cigarette behind his ear, and his pack of cigarettes rolled up in his fucking t-shirt. That's like right. He's from 1950s fucking two. And guess what? So it's another movie, Christmas movie, where two people are sitting in a car telling the story of the killer of the movie.
Yes.
Like Psycho Santa, but shorter in this.
Yes.
Because
you still have to go through this long conversation.
But the dude,
you know, the dude was a decent actor. He wasn't bad. I'll give him that.
90% of the other people in this movie were fucking awful, but yes. Boom Boom, which I'm pretty sure was his character fucking name,
he was a decent
fucking actor.
Yeah.
And he's telling a story of this kid they went to school with named Juan Hsu McGrew.
Doing his best Matt Damon impression.
And how he got this fucking nickname was because his parents were poor and blah blah fucking blah, and he only had one shoe, so he ran around with one shoe, and everybody called him one shoe fucking McGrew. And one of the things that makes this a Christmas movie, the very first thing is that one shoe, he really, really, really wanted another shoe. So he kept writing letters to fucking Santa, saying, I want another shoe. I don't even care if it matches. I just want another shoe.
I mean, he couldn't just go to Payless and just get yourself another fucking pair of shoes.
Well, obviously not. He's poor as fucking shit, right?
Oh, but come on, dude. Everybody can afford one shoe.
I guess.
You could find a shoe on the street. He just wasn't looking hard enough.
I guess he wasn't looking hard
enough. You know, so he went on a rampage because douchebag couldn't find a shoe.
Well, Santa didn't give him a shoe. Santa, meaning his parents, didn't give him a shoe. They, because he liked pirates, they got him an eye patch. And not a cool eye patch. A pussy eye patch, as Boom Boom put it. It was an eye patch with a sequin Christmas tree on it.
Yeah, and he got beat up in high school a lot, I guess.
So he went fucking crazy, and that's when he went on a rampage, and because then he disappeared.
Because his parents gave him an eye patch?
Yes.
My parents have given me Christmas gifts that made me go, ugh. But not
like that Jesus shirt that one year.
Like, you were like, yeah, oh yeah.
That was fucking great, dude. His parents got him a Jesus shirt one year. Yeah. And why was that? Because you saw the Passions of the Christ once?
I think it was. It's like, you know, like I saw it and I was like, oh, okay, whatever. You know, and they were like, oh, you liked it. I was like, nah, really. You know, and they were like, gave me this fucking shirt and shit. It was terrible.
I remember.
Yeah.
Whatever happened to
my parents are like in and out on religion.
What the fuck ever happened to that shirt?
Huh?
What the fuck ever happened to the shirt? Did you keep it? Did you fucking use it for like a spank rag? Because I mean, that'd be pretty fucked up if you were jerking off into the shirt of fucking Jesus.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm not going to. Yeah. I ain't gonna go that far in case I'm wrong. You know, so.
But anyway, should I just.
I think that thing's gone, dude. That thing's long gone. I think I threw that shit away the day I got it.
But anyway, what was I talking about? Okay, but yeah, anyway.
All praise Jason Christ.
All praise Jason Christ. So, anyway, Boom Boom still telling this fucking story how the next year, three of their classmates fucking got killed, and they never found the killer, which everyone knows is One Shoe fucking McGrew.
Yeah, nobody could find this douchebag.
So, whatever, Boom Boom goes out to take a fucking piss. I don't remember what fucking. Oh, yeah.
Wait, you grabbed his balls off.
Yeah, that's right. So, yeah, fucking One Shoe McGrew shows up, grabs his fucking balls off, and rips them fucking off.
Grabs his balls off and rips them off?
Yeah. And then. And then goes.
That makes sense.
And then goes to the fucking car where the chick's at and just grabs her by the throat and then fucking freezes and turns black and fucking white. And we hear some crap news report over top talking about Boom Boom, how he's the coolest guy ever.
Boom.
And the chick, how she had no friends or nothing. Yeah. She was just glad to be hanging out with Boom Boom. And blah, I don't fucking care.
You don't care what happened to Boom Boom?
Well, we know what happened to Boom Boom. Oh, because the news reporter did say that he got his balls ripped off and put in his mouth. Kind of like Papa Wrestling. Except for Papa Wrestling actually fucking showed us.
Oh, he did.
I mean, we saw Boom Boom's fucking nuts ripped off.
Kid's balls, and it was creepy as fuck, but you know. Yeah. But hey.
He was presenting his son. That's good parody.
That's good parody, yeah.
Well, dude, I say that. I've been saying that in a lot of reviews recently.
You're not a parent, dummy.
Yeah.
Thank God you're not.
Why? Because I know good parenting. All you fucking losers that have fucking kids and fucking, you know, let their kids be all fucking crazy psycho, you need to rip a kid's balls off every once in a while. I was just seeing where that train of thought took me. Not nowhere good.
No! I should say not! That took you to the fucking seventh ring of hell!
Oh, fuck.
So yeah, people are gonna be thrilled with that, and you rip the kids' balls off.
Some kids need their bones ripped off.
So anyway, we go from that crap news report to this dude with frosted fucking hair and his fucking chick sitting by a Christmas tree. Number two thing that makes this a Christmas fucking movie. I guess there is a third thing, because when one Hugh McGrew is killing fucking Boom Boom, you do hear jingle, 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 yeah, jingle, bells, jingle bells, like sleigh bells. But anyway, back to the dude, the chick sitting by the Christmas tree. The frosted-haired fucking douche pulls out this fucking suitcase, opens it up, pulls out a whole bunch of handcuffs, and then, like, a stapler, a pop bottle, a fucking steak.
Where's the pop bottle going?
Yeah, well, a big-ass fucking steak. Not like a meat steak, like a steak like you'd stab a fucking vampire with. But painted up.
Yeah, all weird looking.
Duct tape. But whatever. So that he fucking lays the chick down and fucking takes her fucking shirt off. Yeah. And then her fucking bikini top
off. Are you gonna comment on the titties?
Well, she was laying on her back, so you really couldn't tell, but the titties in this movie are weird titties. But like I said before, all titties are fucking awesome. You know, weird titties, big titties, little titties, fucking titties, titties, titties. Because we are masters of the titty arts.
Master of the titty arts.
But anyway, back to the fucking thing. So he handcuffs her to their fucking Walmart fucking couch or whatever. Puts on a watermelon fucking head. Like a fucking...
like a pinata.
Like a pinata. Yeah, he puts on a watermelon pinata on his head and starts fucking her.
Wait, the ice cream scoop.
Oh yeah, I forgot about the ice cream scoop. He had an ice cream scoop and had it on her titties.
He's scooping his titties. And he sat
there fucking her with a watermelon hat on.
That's
when fucking one Hugh McGrew comes out, fucking spins the fucking watermelon pinata and breaks his neck. That was just fucking awesome. He just lightly spins it. But he falls over. The chick doesn't notice this because she's blindfolded with her own pants. I did forget to mention that.
Right. First, I thought it was her underwear, and I was like, ew.
One Hugh McGrew takes off his fucking jean shorts, his fucking basketball short underwear, and what's fucked up is because I've known some fucked up, like, kind of poor people. I mean, I'm poor as fucking dirt. I'm not trying to say it, but wearing basketball shorts is underwear.
Yeah.
It's like, you can't afford actual underwear, but you can afford basketball shorts for underwear? Whatever. Moving on.
Question.
Right, what?
Did you ever have a chick that was freaky like that, that would, like, wanted to use handcuffs and fucking pop bottles and craziness?
No, never pop bottles or nothing. Or ice cream scoops? No, I've never had a chick that was like, put an ice cream scoop on my titty.
No.
But anyway, one Hugh McGrew gets fucking naked, gets on top of the chick, it fades to black, and she's like, oh, you got bigger. Moan, 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 end of fucking scene.
Wow, you make it sound romantic. Bird, bird, bird.
It was fucking one Hugh McGrew basically raping her, and she didn't know it. How's that romantic? Well, maybe you're fucked up by this romantic, but to me, it's not. It's fucking creepy and poorly acted all at the same fucking time.
I didn't mean like it was okay that he did it.
So yeah, this movie is like extra fucking goofy. Like, I guess I'll just get into that shit in a fucking minute, but it is extra fucking goofy, right?
Dive into that when you're ready.
It cuts to this fat dude in a fucking, in shorts, a button-down white fucking dress shirt, and a fucking tie, fucking glasses with the fucking tape in the middle.
Oh, Randy from Trailer
Park. And he's walking down the fucking road, and this fucking redneck picks him up.
Yeah.
And he's like, where are you going there, boy? Ding, dong,
bing. Bang, bing, bang,
boom. And he's like, lame dog hollow. And he's like, got my car. Don't you know fucking young kids died? Lame dog hollow. Ding, 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 dong, ding, dong, ding.
Now I gotta go home and pork pie my sister.
Yee-haw! So he gets the fuck out and just starts walking into Lame Dog fucking Hollow, where other classmates of his are, you know, classmates of fucking one Hugh McGrew.
Right?
So we got, what, the one dude that's wearing rainbow suspenders.
Oh, goofy dude.
Yeah, they're all fucking all goofy. Then there's one dude in a fucking poisonous shirt. And then there's there's a dude that's in a tree with a Green Bay fucking Packers jersey on, playing his guitar to his girlfriend, singing fucking songs about how she's like a fucking electric line or fucking something.
Some shit. I don't know.
And then we got fucking this one chick that her nickname's Honeydew. Because she's wearing this with fucking bikini, and she really does. She stands up and goes, yeah, you might remember me. I'm Honeydew. Bling, bling, bling.
Bling, bling, bling. Yeah. And Honeydew had some big Honeydews.
Yeah, so they're all at Lame Dog Hollow talking and hanging out, you know, and the one dude with the fucking poison shirt's like, my grandparents have a cabin out here. We're going to go have fun. Yay! And then go kill one Hugh McGrew.
We're going to fuck his day up.
That's so what they do, they all fucking toss around balls and have fun.
And they have fun.
And then they go to the fucking cabin.
I thought they were going to be like, I thought there was going to be a scene where they were like, lock and load, and they were getting like guns and shit and fucking.
No, but they go to the cabin and they're like, oh, what are we going to do? Let's play Strip Trivial Pursuit. So that's what they do. But there's no stripping in Strip Trivial Pursuit. They play some Trivial Pursuit while it cuts back and forth to fucking things. I don't even care. Somebody had a brain fart when writing this movie.
They were just like, okay, we're gonna have them. They're like, all right, we're gonna fuck this dude up. Now let's have some fun. It's
going to
be
alright. Oh, sorry, man. I kind of went to a fucking...
A little trance.
Yeah.
But it's going to be alright.
But yeah, yeah.
You want me to read off the notes?
No, it's alright. It's alright.
Some chicken soup.
So, yeah, like I said, the guitar couple, they go out into this fucking boat, and, you know, he's singing a fucking song. Yeah. One human crew fucking gets gross. Them moving the
smell
fuck
like
on.
One open up your poop.
Fucking one shoe kills the fat dude with a chainsaw and for, like, fucking ever... fucking spraying everywhere. Yeah,
you got the fat guy. Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
you got Randy.
Yeah,
whatever his name was.
So whatever. Now we get Honeydew's shower scene in the dirtiest shower I've ever seen in a movie. And I thought before, what was that? What was that movie we did? Where on you a YouTube one where we talked about their dirty ass fucking shower? With the fucking, they were making the porn in that fucking haunted house. Remember the one with fucking demon tits? We did it recently. Demon tits.
Demon tits?
Yeah, the one with the fucking... She was possessed by a fucking Egyptian god. Fucking... We did it for YouTube like a couple fucking YouTubes ago.
You're gonna quiz me now.
What fucking ever. Moving the fuck on.
Dude, I seriously don't remember. You remember?
Whatever. It doesn't matter. Honeydew tits is fucking having a fucking shower in the dirtiest shower fucking ever. And her titties are all huge and fucking soapy. And the radio's talking about making some recipe, but it's all talking about fondling dough in slow motion while she's all fucking boy out.
But the sound effects went back to sci-fi. It was all fucking weird. Everything through the movie, and you're like, what the fuck is happening? Why is there sci-fi music?
Whatever, it doesn't matter. Big Tits gets chased through the fucking woods.
And don't forget the consistent fucking garage band punk music that was going on throughout.
If it wasn't the weird sci-fi 80s techno-y fucking sound effects, it was fucking generic fucking garage punk
And you music. Know what we're talking about.
So whatever, like I said, fuck this movie. We're talking about it too much. I don't want to talk about this movie anymore. So Big Tits gets chased out of the woods, gets tied to a fucking tree. Fucking one shoe stabs her in the fucking puss, then stabs her in the fucking tits, and fucking leaves.
Yeah, well, he cut out her tongue. He did cut out her tongue first. Whatever the hell that red pepper was they threw down the thing.
So, right, there's only these two dudes left. And they're like, we gotta get a Ouija board and go out to the cemetery so we can kill one shoe fucking McGrew. Yeah. They go out to the cemetery, one dude gets killed, the other dude starts fucking with the Ouija board, one shoe comes out, they fucking fight for a while, the fucking dude, which I think was the dude in the poison shirt, ends up stabbing one shoe in the forehead.
He wrestled him down.
And we're like, oh, so that's the end of one shoe McGrew because he's not a ghost or nothing, he's just a fucking dude with one fucking shoe. Yeah. But he gets back up and shotguns the fucking dude in the fucking chest and it looks like he had a fucking predator gun because it's fucking huge fucking hole like smoking. The gore in this movie was pretty decent too. I know I said fuck this movie a lot, but it's an hour long and it's awful.
It's just,
but it's kind of worth watching, I guess. I guess I was just surly at the beginning, so I mean.
Oh, right, so you're calming down now?
A little bit.
Have some more coffee.
It ain't no Labatt, but it'll do.
Well, it's fucking 9-something in the morning.
That'll do, pig. That'll do. So anyway.
Don't hit me with your gorilla hands.
So after he kills the fucking dude with the Predator gun, what does one Juma Groove do?
But he goes the shotgun anyway.
He goes to his family. He goes home to his fucking family. His wife's there and his kid's there, yeah. And they're at the Christmas tree. Guess what? Another Christmas thing!
Yay!
And he's got four Christmas things in his fucking... Yeah, he got a knife in his fucking forehead.
Yeah.
And then his kid opens his fucking present and it's an eye patch with a fucking Christmas tree on it.
And for a moment, the kid's looking at it like, are you fucking kidding me? You know, and then he put it on and he turns around and looks. He's like, dude! And you're like, oh!
And then credits.
Yep. So,
there you go. Then what after the, what happens during the credits? We get like 8 minutes of fucking outtakes. 8 fucking minutes of outtakes of them just fucking up their awful, awful,
do you
awful
know what
lives.
You could do with 8 minutes of your life? There's a lot of things you can do in 8 minutes.
You could have sex 14 times.
I could have sex 100 times in 14 minutes.
Eight minutes.
What did I say?
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
But like, yeah, you're right though. I'd be like, all I do is consistently come. I don't have sex. I just hit it once and go, and eventually fall asleep.
That was disturbing.
Isn't that though?
It's a
medical
note,
condition. Don't make
on me. That note. That has been another Christmas movie. We only have one more Christmas thing left.
Jingle
still the surprise. But can any of you take a guess what it is? What will be our final Christmas episode this year? It's extra special. We have thrown out few hints here and there in episodes. But knowing
what's
us...
What's the worst fucking thing we could possibly do to ourselves?
Yeah. So anyway, if you have a fucking guess, put it down in the comment section fucking below. For Burn Gutter,
this has been another one
of the worst movies on YouTube Netflix episode thing. We'll see you tomorrow
with the extra special. Whatever the fuck we want to do anymore. Like, we have a title of a show, but we just don't give a fuck anymore.
Dude, it was really hard to find Christmas movies to fucking do this year.
Next show will be like, worst, whatever the fuck we want to do.
Well, listen, I wanted to do a fucking worst music videos on YouTube and talk about 80s music videos.
Well, I guess we can do whatever fucking
can't because we'd get hit with copyright really hard if we started putting fucking music videos on there and stuff. So.
Well, you get Metallica would come after you, you know.
Fuck
you'd
them, they're broke.
You'd have Lars at your door and be like, hey, yo.
What, you mean his homeless fucking ass?
He's not a homeless.
He's fucking...
Is he?
No. They're broke, though.
Are they?
Yeah. But anyway.
Well, the
we'll
whole
see
band
you next
is broke.
Week, I guess.
One of them has money.
I don't know.
Come on. They're not broke.
No, they're broke. As a whole, they're broke.
That's great it is.